Welcome to worship on this seventh and final Sunday of our Easter season. A reminder that next Sunday is Pentecost, and if we could worship together, we would remind you to maybe wear red. And you still might want to do that even at home or wherever you are to watch on that very festive Sunday where we celebrate the coming of the Spirit to the disciples. Today we remember that we're in between the Ascension and Pentecost, that waiting period for the disciples. And so we wait and we worship.
Thank you.
We make our beginning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Since we are gathered to hear God's word, call upon him in prayer and praise in the fellowship of this altar. Let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ, and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. Therefore, as a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. O King of glory, Lord of hosts, uplifted in triumph far above all heavens, leave us not without consolation, but send us the Spirit of truth whom you promised from the Father. For you live and reign with him and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Joyful, joyful, we adore you, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before you, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark abyss.
The first reading is from Acts 1, beginning with verse 1. In the first book, O Theophilus, I have dealt with all that Jesus began to do and teach until the day when he was taken up after he had given commands through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. To them he presented himself alive after his suffering by many proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. And while staying with them, he ordered them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know times or seasons that the Father has fixed by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. And when he had said these things, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. And while they were gazing into heaven as he went, behold, two men stood by them in white robes and said, men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into heaven? This Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. In Psalms 47. Clap your hands, all peoples. Shout to God with loud songs of joy. For the Lord, the Most High, is to be feared, a great king over all the earth. He subdued people under us and nations under our feet. He chose our heritage for us, the pride of Jacob, whom he loves. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the shout of a trumpet. Sing praises to God. Sing praises. Sing praises to the King. Sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth. Sing praises with a psalm. God reigns over the nations. God sits on his holy throne. The princes of the peoples gather as the people of God of Abraham. For the shields of the earth belong to God. He is highly exalted. Next reading is 1 Peter chapter 4, beginning with verse 12. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery trial when it comes upon you to test you as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice insofar as you share Christ's sufferings, that you may also rejoice and be glad when his glory is revealed. If you are insulted by the name of Christ, you are blessed, because the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. But let none of you suffer as a murderer or a thief or an evildoer or as a meddler. Yet if anyone suffers as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God in that name. For it is time for judgment to begin at the household of God. And if it begins with us, what will be the outcome for those who do not obey the gospel of God? And if the righteous is scarcely saved, what will become of the ungodly and the sinner? Therefore, let those who suffer according to God's will entrust their souls to a faithful Creator while doing good.
The Holy Gospel for this Sunday, the seventh Sunday of Easter, is written in John chapter 17, beginning with verse 1, where Jesus prays for himself and for his disciples. It's often entitled the High Priestly Prayer, again spoken on that first Maundy Thursday evening when Jesus celebrated the Passover with his disciples. After Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the time has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you. For you granted him authority over all people, that he might give eternal life to all those you have given him. Now this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have brought you glory on earth by completing the work you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory that I had with you before the world began. I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours, you gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. For I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And glory has come to me through them. I will remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one. The Gospel of our Lord. Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Our text for our sermon this morning is taken from that first lesson, the story of Jesus' ascension, but especially the verses just following up to verse 14 of Acts chapter 1. Then they, the disciples, returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had entered the city, they went to the room upstairs where they were staying. Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew, Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer together with certain women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, as well as his brothers. In the name of Jesus, dear Christian friends. It's a child's birthday. He's 6 years old, and he just cannot wait to open his presents for the day. In fact, the night before, he was begging his parents, "When I get up in the morning, can I open a present?" And they said, "Well, after breakfast." But he was so excited that morning, they relented and said, "Okay, you can open one present." And so he does. Tears into the box, opens it up, and here is a toy he always wanted. It was a dump truck that would get on a track and go around. And he got to a certain point, it would stop, and there was a little hydraulic thing that would go and dump out marbles. But there was one thing that was wrong. The parents, in their excitement and in their haste in buying the present, did not notice those little words that were on the box: "Batteries not included." So what do you do? The parents said, "Well, as soon as breakfast is over, Dad'll go and buy some batteries. But you've got to wait till then." He's 6 years old, and he had to wait. Now, you and I all know what it's, can remember, I hope, how tough it is for a child to wait. We've probably had experiences like that too, haven't we? We're in it right now, waiting for this pandemic, this COVID-19 thing, to get past so we can resume some kind of normalcy in our lives. Till we can resume worshiping together. And we're told week after week, you gotta wait. You know, every Tuesday morning, pastors in our two circuits, 4 and 19 here in the Sacramento area, at least many of us, get together on a Zoom meeting, just talking about ministry and about what we're going through. And it's interesting because this past Tuesday, it seems like the waiting and the patience was beginning to run thin. You know, there is the passage, we ought to obey God rather than men, and God tells us to worship. But we're told to wait. And so all kinds of discussion went on. Waiting, waiting, waiting. You know how long 10 days is? That's all it was for the disciples. But Jesus didn't tell them that. He says, "Go into the city and wait for the Spirit to come." They did not know how long it was going to be. You and I know it was only 10 days. And, you know, the older we get, well, 10 days we'll wait. Except when you're waiting for that medical report to come back. And they say it's a week or 10 days. It's an eternity. It's an eternity. It's tough to wait. And sometimes there's unnecessary waiting too. But the point is, God tells us to wait. What did they do when they waited? They devoted themselves to prayer and to being together. They were together. And so, even in our waiting period, you and I are called to be together. And Today, I think many of you are worshiping or hearing this at the same time. In one sense, we're waiting together. Are you praying? Are you keeping others in your prayers? Are you contacting them? Are you working at being the church where you are, no matter where, whether you walk, go into work, and hopefully some of you can and do, or you're working from home? We're called to wait. And so the disciples were called to wait. But even in that period of time, often we become timid or fearful or afraid. We become so wrapped up in our own needs that we forget about the needs of others or the needs of the rest of the world, the rest of the church and its ministries. We dare never let that happen for us. For us, that great outpouring of the Spirit that the disciples experienced on Pentecost is past history. But that same Spirit has been given to us. I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And also with that baptism comes that promise of the Spirit to fill us and to be with us always. That's how we came into this Christian community, through our baptisms. The baptism that said we are born again of water and the Spirit. And that's good news for us. That's power for us to continue ministry and to work at ministry in the periods of our waiting time. We don't have to wait for that Spirit as the disciples did. It's not unlike Dietrich Bonhoeffer, who was waiting in the Nazi prison because of his faith. It's in any kind of life situation that doesn't have to overwhelm us. And Bonhoeffer wrote this from prison. A spiritual heritage reaching back for centuries is a wonderful support and comfort in the face of all temporary stresses and strains. I believe that the person who is aware of such reserves of power need not be ashamed of the feelings evoked by a rich and valuable past. It's at precisely such a time as this that you and I need to, as Martin Luther once said, swim back to our baptisms and remind ourselves that the promise made by Jesus at his ascension has been fulfilled for us. We have been baptized. We have been given the gift of the Holy Spirit and therefore have his presence and power to turn to for help in whatever situation we find ourselves. And that power is more than the, quote, the force of Star Wars fame. It's the power of the triune God we worship. It's the power brought to us in word and sacrament daily. Prayer is the vehicle. His word is the vehicle. His sacraments are the vehicle. Studying alone and with others are the vehicles. Get into that vehicle. Confidently then, each one of us can move forward in ministry, can go into the world this week going assured that we don't have to wait anymore for the power that is ours, and the Spirit goes with us. And that's something to live and celebrate with. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which truly passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus. Amen. We confess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We worship the Lord with our offerings, mailed or brought into the church office. In our prayers this morning, we continue to remember Kathy Simonek undergoing treatment, chemotherapy for cancer, and also for Addie Forsyth, who has returned back to her home or to her dwelling place and is in skilled nursing care at Eschaton in these days. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Almighty and merciful God, we give you thanks for your mercy, especially for the salvation you have prepared for the whole world through the suffering and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Enable us to walk by faith, enduring all trials encountered because of that faith, as we deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that you rule and govern your holy church throughout the world, granting your blessing to all you have called to preach your holy word, in order that we be preserved in pure doctrine of your saving word, and that we bear witness to your saving truth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give health, wisdom, and protection to all who are in authority of making, administering, and judging our laws in order that they rule according to your good will and pleasure. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give your comfort to all who are in trouble, want, sickness, peril of death, or any other adversity. We remember this morning especially Adeline and Kathy and those whom we silently name in our hearts. Grant courage and steadfastness, especially to those who suffer for your name's sake, that they receive and accept their afflictions in the confidence that you will acknowledge them as your own. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We remember with thanksgiving those who have loved and served you in your church on earth, who now rest from their labors. Keep us in fellowship with all your saints, and bring us at last to the joys of your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who has taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ through the eternal covenant, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will. And may he work in us what is pleasing to him, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, serve the Lord.